I see you.
This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead. After many trials and tribulations, Geralt finally learned that Yen was in nearby Vizima.
The gentleman will address the Emperor only when asked to, and using the appropriate title.
Your Arch-Magnificency.
I see the gentleman is in the mood for jests. I fear the Emperor might not share his disposition.
Your Majesty will suffice. Spoken loudly, clearly, and with respect.
Imgrimi et art kerzer. Dyfen aden in karn eb marvut. Emir var emreis.
Bow. Your Imperial Majesty.
Arer ep tho orde.
Avelian namin, vatgan favot. I thought you bowed before no man.
Didn't want to disappoint the Chamberlain. We're friends. Take it you didn't summon me to reminisce about the good old days, so...
Silence. My daughter Cirilla, she's returned. And she's in danger. The Wild Hunt pursues her. You will find her and bring her to me.
How many men in your army? 20,000? 30? So why me?
You know why. Because she trusts you.
She trusts me, yes. So tell me why you're looking for her. Doubt it's about making up for all those lost years.
For reasons of state, as always. Enough of this banter. You will agree regardless, if for no other reason than because I shall pay you more than you customarily receive for a contract. Considerably more.
Save your generosity for those whose homes your armies have raised. I'll do it for Ciri, not for your gold.
Your motives do not interest me. Only results. Yennefer will tell you the rest. This audience is finished. Merarid! Take him to the sorceress.
Sure, Evay.
Follow me, if the gentleman pleases. Please keep close. There are many honorable guests in the palace. Whom the gentleman...
Disgusts.
Need not bother.
And
it's past noon!
Come, sir.
What? Do you know who you're talking to, soldier? I'm Herivard II, Prince of Elandia. Not only am I made to wait here like some supplicant...
Rad sleeten eh enekt estun es saur an nefeind.
Es sieht Efsa,
Efsa nein
Matthew. Es macht Gott, es ma streger Efsa.
If ein Kirche, es deithwin adnken kann et Morvul.
Es ist gleich, kin bed brein et gart, en selfit den Barthe, das se plenken et not man, en selfit den Sigler. Kasper ken du belle der, du meva.
Once the gentleman is done, he should see me to retrieve his possessions. Once the gentleman is done, he should see me to retrieve his possessions.
Will sharpen yet. Yes? Then transcribe. The true authority in Novigrad is not the city council or the merchant's guild.
tunic. You look positively smashing.
Ugh, dying to take it off.
I'd consider that a proposition under different circumstances. One I might even take you up on. But we've matters to attend to. Now do you understand why I'm at Emir's court?
Mm-hmm. And seems we're in the same boat now. Ciri, she's really back? No chance he's mistaken?
Look, that's more or less what she looks like now. Or so our agents claim. Our little witch has grown into a young lady.
Huh. So they're our agents now? My, my. You've clearly settled in quick.
Geralt, don't twist my words. I know who Emir is. He started this war and its bloodshed. He had my friends killed. But I haven't any other choice, so please, let's not belabor the pros and cons, and instead focus on finding Ciri. All right?
Right. Emir said the Wild Hunt's after her. I'd find that hard to believe, before what happened yesterday. How did they track us down?
Because of me. You see, I've spent months searching for Ciri. Using locating spells, haruspicy, geomancy, anything, really. I knew the Wild Hunt might sense it, perhaps even find me, but I thought I'd tricked them.
Well, guess you were wrong.
Hmm. I've sensed them on my trail, hunting me, for some time. If not for you and Emir's soldiers, they'd have gotten what they were after. I can't risk another encounter like that. It's time to put away the magic, turn to more traditional methods. To the best tracker I know. You must find her, Geralt. Before the Wild Hunt does.
The Wild Hunt? What could it want from Ciri?
I've no clue, Geralt. Might have written them to ask, but I don't have their address. I know as much as you do. It must be about her blood. Her gift. As for what the Hunt wishes to do with that gift, I'd prefer not to think about it, really.
So where's Ciri been seen, exactly?
In two places. Velen and Novigrad. The trail in Velen is most promising. You should make that your first stop. Ask for a merchant named Hendrik at the inn at the crossroads. One of the Emperor's agents. He should get in touch with you.
That's it? No passwords? Secret handshakes?
None. Sorry to spoil your fun. Your boyhood fantasies about the crafts of the trade. All we have in Novigrad are unconfirmed reports, rumors. But there you will have the help of our mutual acquaintance. Triss Merigold. Apparently she's got a cozy flat on the main square.
Sure she'll be delighted to see me. What about you? What will you do?
I shall sail for Skellige. There was a magic explosion there recently. It blew half a forest down. I believe this had something to do with Ciri. I'll be in Caer Trold. Join me there once you've learned something.
One thing before we go. Why didn't you contact me? Didn't need me? Didn't even want to see me?
I didn't want to spoil things. I'd heard you and Triss made a great couple.
Yen, I'd lost my memory.
Really? That's your excuse? Let's drop it, all right? It's not what you think, or... It helped me understand how much I love you. I don't wish to hear it. Any of it.
Guess this means we need to split up again. Not my preference, but I understand. Clock's ticking.
It is indeed. So why don't I teleport you to Velen, get you there at once?
Not gonna happen. I'll go on horseback, as soon as I can get changed.
Have it your way? Oh, and you really look quite dashing in black velvet.
Think so? Maybe I can have some of my armor lined with it. Good luck, Yen.
Same to you. And if you wish to learn what's happened in the world while you and Vesemir roam the wilderness, talk to Ambassador Vaartra. That's him over there. And Geralt. I know it's wartime, but try not to be a hero, all right? Just check those leads and come back to me, in one piece. I shall be waiting.
Scars healed nicely.
Be so kind and do not disturb. A shame.
Ambassador Varatra, Yennefer suggested I ask you about current events, the war and so on.
Of course. The Emperor's servants should keep no secrets from each other. If you will, let us approach the map.
How's the war going? I mean, apart from the fact that Nilfgaard's triumph is imminent.
I assume this to be a private conversation. We've no witnesses, so let's dispense with the propaganda, even that shrouded in irony. Our offensive was going splendidly until winter came. Edirne was in such disarray that we encountered no resistance. We had reached the Pontar before the first snows. Only a weakened Kedwin remained, and Radovid's Redania, which had ignored the rest of the North's pleas for help. We thought they'd sue for peace, perhaps even submit to vassalization. We waited for spring, certain of victory.
Radovid? Submit?
Yes, a vain hope, I agree. Radovid sent no peace envoys, nor did he advance on our positions. Instead, he trudged over the snow-bound Kestrel Mountains and attacked Kedwin, his ally. This attack took the Kedweni by surprise. They were still mourning the loss of their king. Rudderless and dejected, they laid down their arms after a few lost skirmishes and joined Radovid.
And so by spring, instead of two weak enemies, we had only one powerful one.
That admiration I hear in your voice?
Radovid is our foe, but I cannot deny he is clever. He played us for fools, particularly dense ones at that. Returning to the war, this spring there was a massive battle in the marshes of Velen. Massive, yet indecisive. Both sides suffered enormous losses, unprecedented even. Radovid has retreated across the Pontar. He's safe for now, until reinforcements arrive from the south. Then Emperor Emir Var Emrys will deal with him once and for all.
Couldn't you just go home? Save everyone a lot of marching, not to mention a few human lives.
I'm afraid the stakes are too high to fold now. We can only go all in.
How do things look in Velen?
As bad as ever, perhaps worse. This land never flowed with milk and honey, and now it flows with blood. Armies have swept through it several times, trampling fields, looting granaries, burning villages. Famine grips the populace.
Mm-hmm. So how's ruling that earthly paradise going for you?
Not well, to be honest. Our forces are spread thin as it is, and Velen is chiefly swampy forests that are difficult to control. We've had several patrols never return to their camps. Thus, we've temporarily delegated authority in this region to a certain Nordling, a former low-ranking officer in the Temerian army, one Philip Strenger, better known by his nom de guerre, the Bloody Baron. I advise you well, avoid him.
Any news from Novigrad? Is the Free City still free?
Yes, although everyone knows this won't last. Radovid is in Oxenford, and the Emperor is here in Vizima, at Novigrad's doorstep, both. And both require coin and ships. Novigrad can provide these. Which is why the mood in the city is rather, well, on edge.
Meaning?
How do men deal with fear? They seek reassurance and scapegoats. The Church of the Eternal Fire understands this perfectly, and so it promises to improve the lives of its flock by pointing out the guilty. Who started the war? Who profits from it? Why, it's obvious. Mages, elves, dwarves, in a word, any and all deviants. I've been stationed in Novigrad for 13 years, first as a consul, then as ambassador. I've seen a great deal. Cruelty, cynicism, greed. But what is happening there now concerns me greatly.
What's new in Skellige?
Nothing. The islanders pride themselves on that, don't they? Doing everything according to tradition, as their forefathers did. And like their forefathers, they quarrel with each other. Pillage. Occasionally attack our transports. This is cumbersome, but nothing more. Skellige has always been a footnote to history, and so it shall remain.
Sound awfully confident. What if King Bran manages to unite the Jarls? Lead all the clans against your fleet?
King Bran is a feeble old man. From what I know, he barely remembers the names of his own vassals. Uniting all might prove difficult.
Thanks for your help.
Think nothing of it. May the great sun light your path.
How might I serve the gentleman?
By returning my things.
Citrus and cloves. The fragrance will keep the gentleman's robes fresh somewhat longer.
Thanks, bunches.
The Emperor is not known for his patience. He wants his daughter back safe and sound, as soon as possible.
Yeah, mention something of the sort. So long.
unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
See you.
Nin to me.
Geralt and Yennefer were reunited, but something even more important happened in Vizima. Geralt learned that Cirilla, his one-time ward, had returned from afar, and she was in danger. He was to find her, at the Emperor's command and Yennefer's behest.
faster.
Strangers
Snow
coming!
No.
Run for your lives!
I'll not give her up, not on me life!
Looking for a man, goes by Hendrik.
What do you want with him?
Wanna talk to him.
What about?
Give me a bottle of something strong.
You gotta go. I'll open the back way for you.
Haven't finished my drink yet.
Innkeep, vodka.
Who's this?
Brave warrior, looks like. Got two swords, see?
Oi, great boy. What's the point of having two swords?
Wonder if he keeps an extra prick in his trousers, too.
You fucking deaf. Gonna say who you are? Or do I need to loosen your tongue with me knife?
I'm a witcher. Heard you wondering about my swords. Well, one's for monsters, the other for humans. Only got one prick, though, in case you're wondering about that, too.
Don't touch him. Don't even look at him. Worse than lepers, that lot.
Saw one in action once. Killed a half dozen. Blood everywhere. Freak didn't even show a drop of sweat.
Got the stench of corpses on him.
If you want a rest, come with me. Or the bench you can use.
I step in the hut, and there's the bumpkin with what looks like his son. That's on the pretty side, I think, of himself.
I say probably disguised.
Thanks for not starting a row with those swine.
I don't generally poke my nose in other people's business.
Looking to stay the night?
No.
Huh.
I'm looking for Hendrik.
Man lives in Heatherton.
Don't know where that is.
Other side of the hill. Looked that away this morning, saw a strange glow. Imperials on the raid, perhaps. But who knows?
Anything else you can tell me about Hendrik?
Odd fellow. Arrived from who knows where and for no apparent reason. Shacked up with a widow whose husband was stabbed for a scrap of bread.
Baron's men don't like strangers.
Aye, he stays out of their way. Always seems to know when they're coming. Always manages to disappear.
Thanks, Innkeep.
Have a look. You've got a young daughter, Ramsay.
Oh, no.
What is that? Sorted, Roach. Won't be no use to anyone if you start. Trap on the loot. We're done here.
Find me before the next ones come.
When they come, I'll tend to them. Meanwhile, let's you and me chat. Like to know who I'm untying.
John Verdon. Served in the 10th Maribor Division.
Long way from your army.
The army don't exist no more. Black One smashed it to bits. I scarpered off into the woods just before that happened. Join a group of refugees. Fucking bursting with patriotism, they were. As soon as they learned I'd abandoned Temeria in her hour of need, they beat me down. Tied me up like a turkey, left me to the drowners.
Fine, I'll help.
Oh, thanks. For a minute there, I was almost sure you'd leave me to die. I'd like to thank you somehow, but I've not a chip crown to my name.
Tough. I'll take the loss.
Thanks, Witcher. May you prosper on the path.
What do you want?
Rejoice, for even a creature as depraved and base in nature as you can serve the glory of the eternal fire. Someone must see to the corpses on the battlefield. Necrophages defile those not already rotting in mass graves. This is not right.
That's to be my good deed for the day?
A handsomely profitable one, I might add. I know your kind don't work for free.
All right, I'll take care of it.
This will count amongst your merits. The more good one works in life, the more hallowed things are. Yes, splendid. Here are the holy oils. Dash generously and set alight, understood? I wish it to flare up to the sky, for the glory of the eternal fire and all that.
Once I've incinerated the bodies, where'll I find you?
I shall be near the bridge to Novigrad.
Move it! Let's go!
Yeah, sure stinks like a mass grave. Now for the holy oil. Must be going well. A shot of Igni.
Not so fast, Roach. Faster. Slower.
Yeah, sure stinks like a mass grave. For a shot of Igni.
Take it easy. Move it.
Shit, one still alive.
If it ain't that fucking priest, it's corpse eaters. I'm done with this damn town.
A priest?
We'd agreed to meet as usual, just a larger delivery. Good customer, I thought. Then they whipped out blades.
We still talking about a priest of the Eternal Fire?
I'd say so. Beat state pricks can't be trusted. This one had ordered premium grade Fistech from me 3 times. Everything perfect, but the fourth, his man came at us with knives, sought to knock us out of trade. Shoved me in that ditch with the corpses. Must have thought the ghouls would take care of the rest.
And to make sure, he hired a witcher to burn the bodies, destroy any evidence.
A witcher? Meaning you? So what now?
Nothing. Didn't pay me to burn the living.
Oh, thank the gods, it's true what they say. Though mutants, you live by a code. Oh, thank you, witcher.
Now for a shot of Igni.
Let's go!
slower.
Well, Witcher, have you completed your task?
Why do you priests take an interest in the Fallen so late?
The Church of the Eternal Fire's first duty is to the living. You've no notion of the work we did just after the battle. The wounded needed tending, refugees, pastoral care. We had sermons to deliver, donations to collect.
Relieved to hear it. What would the people have done without you? So, took care of the graves. Interesting, actually. One of the corpses proved to be quite, well, alive. And pretty talkative.
What do you mean?
Fistech dealer. One of them survived. Had an awfully interesting story to tell.
Intriguing. I would purchase this story from you. For all time. Exclusively.
You can hire me, but you sure as hell can't buy me.
Ah, an impasse. Then it will be cheapest to kill you.
3-on-1. Surely we'll manage, Witcher or not. Take him!
Let's dance.
Interest you in a pass. Cheapest around, right here.
What kind of pass are we talking about?
You don't know. Redanians hold all the fords across the Pontar. Can't get through without a pass. But you're in luck. So happens I've got a few to sell.
What? Could dress up like Radovid and buy a gilded carriage for that much.
What am I to do if you can't afford it?
No deal.
Whoa, hold up. Might have a little work for you. Reduce the price for a job well done, eh?
What kind of work?
Nearby. Just to the southeast. My sister's husband's got a business. He and some lads tidy up battlefields. Problem is, there's always swarms of shite bothering them. You know, in monsters drawn to corpses. Give them some protection, and I'll swing you one beautiful discount.
All right, see what I can do. What is it?
Got work for you, because you look to me eyes like a witcher. Am I right?
What do you need?
Need for my men to finish their work unharmed. But we got corpse-eaters coming out all the while. Rid us of them, and we'll give you a share.
Deal.
What now?
stench.
Halt! No passage. Bridge is closed.
Because?
Because King Radovid said it should be. Won't let anyone through who don't have a pass.
Who issues these passes?
Why, you need to know. Your kind don't get passes anyway. Not the right type.
Come on, give it a good think. I'm sure you know where I can get a pass.
Yeah. Royal officials issue them. But they're also available on the black market.
From who?
Don't know the names. Ask folk around the crossings. They'll know more.
Do just that. Farewell.
You again, looking for a pass? I've got a special price for you.
I actually ran into your brother-in-law. Tended to the monsters too, but he was killed.
What? You pulling me leg? Forget my offer. It's off the table, you git. On your way. Go on now. You're scaring the other places off.
Now here's a
snow. Passes in the Novigrad won't find them cheaper anywhere else. Transit passes at terrific prices.
In Daniel, when a witch.
What do you want?
They send her to the woods.
Kill the monsters.
All of them.
Transit passes at terrific prices.
Oh, it's you.
Who issues these pass?
Why, you need...
My kind has its ways. We just have to know where to look.
Ah, oh, well, that's different. It's royal officials who issue the official passes.
Take it there are also unofficial ones, then.
Contraband. If you will, black market issue. You might ask folk near the crossings.
Do just that. Farewell.
Whoa!
On your way.
Best give grown poach a
long scram. Thought I'd lose my patience.
You won't grab her out to truly the wild. We just start.
Is at the terrific prices.
with you.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
Long live Radovid! Out of the way!
Huh?
What the fuck? Choked to death on 3 pounds of steam.
Troll, back on me, you rock.
Halt! No passage.
Case of the plague surface in the city or something?
The plague? No. We're to not let folk in the city. It's an order, so I don't, unless someone's got a pass.
What kind of pass are we talking about?
Well, a normal one. A transit pass.
Who issues them?
How should I know? I'm a lowly soldier.
Who ordered the city gates closed?
Word is the king himself. Doesn't want paupers and refugees pissing all over his beautiful city. Apart from which, when folk can go hither and thither, always a chance some spy will sling through. This way, spies got it harder. So, no pass, no passage.
Farewell.
The same at Etterex.
Your kind spreads disease, defeatism, and desertion. Feisty, eh?
Stay out.
out of my way.
Something.
Hey, Whitey. Why'd your hair go white?
Ooh. Huh? A nice old gran.
Has she got a black cat? She has. Dried herbs.
You hear her wailing yesterday. What did they do to that?
Same as always. Started with her fingernails.
The eternal flame will burn away our sins.
Honour and the fatherland.
Ah, a customer.
Show me what you got on offer.
Thank you.
customer.
Show me what you got on offer. Farewell.
Stay out of my way.
You hear her wailing yesterday. They do that.
Same as always. Honoring the father, lad.
Let's go! Run, Roach! Giddy up! Slower. Let's go!
sent to Tamir. Where it is, the box.
Strange, like dropping into a deep cellar on a hot day, and the mist.
Damn, you're ugly.
Be gone! Leave me be, whoever you is! Get away!
Calm down. It's over.
Aye. It's over. All's past, never to be restored. I'll not forget that ever.
Looking for a man named Hendrik, supposed to live in this village.
Aye, he did. No longer. They nabbed him in that hut. If you'd have heard the cries, sir. If you'd have heard how a man can scream. How he can suffer.
Tell me what happened here, step by step.
They took him. Took them all. The sun was waning, see, and the dusk went crimson like blood. Thought to myself, strange, the toads, I cannot hear them. Save terror through and through. Hendrik screamed. Then he begged. By the end, he could do naught but moan.
Just wonderful.
Weren't here long, the terrors. Yet the village froze like in the heart of winter.
You in that hut when they rode off?
No, and I'll not set foot there. Never.
Farewell, and peace of mind to you. Tortured him. Maybe they missed something. Need to check his pockets. Trousers are stiff, as if hung out to dry midwinter. Maybe hid something in his jerkin. Damn, he's cold as ice. Nothing here. Should check his boots. Blood congealed. Key key hidden in his boot. Gotta fit a keyhole. Somewhere nearby, hopefully. There's a draft. Gotta be a space under this rubble. Guess I should do some cleaning. Valuables left unlocked, on display, almost. Lost his mind, or... Interesting. A ledger. Payment for a sack of grain. Amount due for a charcoal shipment. Hendrik was masquerading as a merchant. What's this? Notes among the ledger entries. Clever. Interesting headings. Missing and wanted. Subject appeared in Skellige. Also sighted in Novigrad. Appearance unchanged. Ashen hair. Scar on her face. Avoids contact with others. Drunken swine. So-called Baron hosted subject at his castle, or should I say, illegally appropriated fort. Reason unknown. Talked to Baron at Crow's Perch. Clashed with a witch. Subject landed in swamp, encountered a witch. Conflict ensued. Cause unknown. Find the witch. Talk to the peasantry. Village of Midcops. Caution advised. I'm being observed. Don't know by whom or why. Unsettling signs. Dog ran off. Water in bucket froze solid. Strange glow observed in the sky. Ill omen, peasants say. Somehow they learned Hendrik was looking for Ciri. Thus the torture. I'm too late. My only leads, the Baron, and some witch. Damn. Thank you. Greetings.
Salutations! Whither do you come from, and where will you go?
Hard to say. Seen a lot of the world and plan to see more.
As have I, as do I.
Not the best place for a traveling peddler.
Profits lie amidst risk. True, the wars brought strife and hardship, but folk live on, and where there is life, there is trade.
Prepared to risk your life for a bit of coin?
Coin, my friend, is of little import. Hard as I try, I simply cannot remain still, so I wander and wander the world. I see new places, speak with folk I've never known. It's what I like, and that's worth the risk.
Take a peek if you don't mind. Farewell.
We'll meet again. I know this.
You, white one.
What's your business? Bloody Baron over
here? Yeah?
Craft special order weapons too?
Do politicians murder high-class prostitutes? Of course.
Got this diagram. Think you can forge the weapon? So long.
That
looking for a hunter named Neelan.
Found him. What do you want?
Hear about your notice. I'm a witcher. When do you last see your wife?
5 days passed, before dawn. On my way out to hunt, she were asleep. We come back, found no sign of her.
Maybe she went to the neighboring village, forgot to tell you.
No. My sister were never gone this long before.
Tried looking for her?
Asked around the village, none saw her go. She must have left when they were still sleeping. Told her time and again not to wander off on her own. She never listened.
I must have some menfolk to scour the woods. Nothing.
I'll look in the woods. You might have missed something. Ask around, too. She have any friends?
Hanneket keeps to herself, mostly. Watches the blacksmith's young'uns at times. And in the village, Glenna, the butcher's wife, she likes her best.
Thanks. I'll try to find her, but no promises. Greetings, you Glenna?
Aye. But gristle and marrow is all I'm willing to sell, and you'll have to wait till I'm done carving it.
Wanted to talk to you about Hannah. Hear you were friendly.
She come by at times? We talk?
She seems strange lately. Any idea where she might have gone?
Strange? No? A cheerful soul always. If I'm to judge, it's the wolves got her. Been howling the nights through lately. Even the Baron's men are feared to come by. Hannah must have gone to the wood to gather mushrooms, maybe. Strayed too deep and the howler's got her.
You the butcher's wife?
Butcher? Please. Might have called him a butcher when we lived in the shade of Novigrad's walls. Now he deals in carrion, fallen animals. Their bones still fit for soup. So, buying something?
Thanks. Farewell.
But he would have Hannah. If it weren't for our
parents. Wow. My dad used to make swords like yours. Can I touch it?
It's sharp. Better not. Need to talk to your father.
I forged swords once. Now it's scythes and hoes. For good arms, you'll need to go to Novigrad.
Wanted to ask you about Hannah. Heard she looked after your children.
Aunt Hannah? Do you know where she is?
No. That's why I'm here. She maybe tell you where she was going, or anything else?
She said turnips are healthy, and we ought to eat them.
I saw her go to the forest, with another lady. It was dawn almost. I'd gone out so I wouldn't wet the pallet.
The forest? She's done for.
Why?
A huge pack roams the area. None from the village dares go in the forest. Neelan's only one not afeared, but then he's a hunter.
Did you get a good look at the other woman? Know who it was?
No. She walked in front of Aunt Hannah. I couldn't see.
Thanks. Farewell.
Witcher?
What are you doing here? Shouldn't be in the forest alone.
I came to tell you. You needn't look for Hannah. She'd have returned long past were she alive. I'll pay you twice Neelan's pledge. Just tell the man his Hannah's dead.
Don't want to know what happened to her?
I've no illusions, Witcher. In Velen, you're gone as long as she's been. You don't come back. Hannah's dead for certain. Neelan ought to accept his loss. Move on with his life.
Sorry, not in the habit of leaving jobs undone.
Folks speak true about you, Witchers. You're heartless beasts.
No man did this. Cuts. Made with long claws. Flesh torn clear off. This is getting interesting. Claw marks. Deep. Must be Hannah.
Smell of a rotting corpse.
Torn to pieces, literally.
Blood spattered all around. Werewolf. No doubt about it. Gotta be careful. Shit. Climbed the tree. I can't get up there. Maybe find something else on the ground. Blood and paw marks. Wonder where they lead. Shit. Climbed the tree. I can't get up there. Maybe find something else on the ground. Shit. Climbed the tree. I can't get up there. Maybe find something else on the ground.
Tuft of fur. Whatever lost it hasn't bathed in a while.
man's clothes. Shredded, but no sign of blood. Who rips their own clothes off, leaves them in the woods? Looks like a hunter's quarters. It's just barely dried. He was dragged here. Wonder where from.
insane? Stand back, he's dangerous.
Not to me, he's not. It's Nalan.
Lycanthropy can afflict anyone, but it is a curse, so sorry, but I have to.
You don't understand. I love him. He was near to being mine till you came along. Go away! Leave us be!
Not till I find out what's going on here.
I love him. Always have. Even after I'd learned his secret.
You knew? Did you know I shut myself in here to wait out me change?
I knew, and I didn't mind. But you chose Hannah. I wanted her to see you. I wanted her to fear you. She'd not have stayed. And we could be together.
You brought her here. That night. It was the reason I had the taste of blood in me mouth come morn.
I did it for us. She was to see you turn, not more. I didn't want her death. You've got to believe me.
I don't. And I'll kill you willingly. First time for that, in fact.
You won't kill anyone, ever again.
No! Don't hurt him!
Get out of here before I change my mind. Run. You insane?
It's Nalan!
Like...
You don't...
Not till I find...
I knew.
You...
I did it for us!
I don't.
You won't kill anyone, ever again.
No!
Get out of here before... Run.